to this topic, limit at infinity with square root in the numerator. Let us find the limit of the square root of 9x squared minus 2x divided by 4x plus 3 as x approaches negative infinity. If we are going to find the limit by direct substitution, the result will be infinity over negative infinity, which is indeterminate. So we should not apply direct substitution. What we shall do is to divide its term of the radicand in the numerator by the variable with the largest exponent, in this case, x squared. So this is now equal to the square root of 9x squared over x squared minus 2x over x squared, and then multiply 9x squared over x squared minus 2x over x squared by x squared. You can write x squared after the parenthesis or before the parenthesis. It doesn't matter because multiplication is commutative. The variable with the largest exponent in the denominator is x. So divide 4x by x, and then plus 3 over x. Multiply 4x over x plus 3 over x by x. This is now equal to the square root of x squared times the quantity 9 minus 2 over x divided by x times the quantity 4 plus 3 over x. X squared times the quantity 9 minus 2 over x is equal to 9x squared minus 2x. And x times the quantity 4 plus 3 over x is equal to 4x plus 3. We can now apply this property of radicals. The nth root of a times b is equal to the nth root of a times the nth root of b. So we can write the numerator as the square root of x squared times the square root of the quantity 9 minus 2 over x divided by x times the quantity 4 plus 3 over x. Now, in algebra, we learned that the square root of x squared can be written as the absolute value of x. And the absolute value of x is equal to x or positive x if x is greater than or equal to 0, and it is equal to negative x or the negative of x if x is less than 0. Now, we can replace the square root of x squared by the absolute value of x. This is now equal to the absolute value of x times the square root of the quantity 9 minus 2 over x divided by x times the quantity 4 plus 3 over x. We know that the square root of x squared is equal to the absolute value of x, and the absolute value of x is equal to x or positive x if x is greater than or equal to 0, and it is equal to negative x or the negative of x if x is less than 0. We are solving for the limit of the function as x approaches negative infinity. So x is less than 0, therefore the absolute value of x is equal to negative x. That is, we can replace the absolute value of x here by negative x because x is less than 0. So we have now negative x times the square root of the quantity 9 minus 2 over x divided by x times the quantity 4 plus 3 over x. We can cancel negative x and x. This is now equal to negative square root of the quantity 9 minus 2 over x divided by the quantity 4 plus 3 over x. We can now find the limits of the numerator and the denominator. So this is now equal to negative square root of the limit of 9 as x approaches negative infinity minus the limit of 2 over x as x approaches negative infinity divided by the limit of 4 as x approaches negative infinity plus the limit of 3 over x as x approaches negative infinity. This is now equal to negative square root of 9 minus 0 over 4 plus 0. 9 because the limit of 9 as x approaches negative infinity is 9. 0 because the limit of 2 over x as x approaches negative infinity is 0. 4 because the limit of 4 as x approaches negative infinity is 4. And the limit of 3 over x as x approaches negative infinity is 0. So this is now equal to negative square root of 9. 9 minus 0 is 9. And then 4 plus 0 is 4. So over 4. This is now equal to negative 3 divided by 4 or negative 3 over 4. So the answer is negative 3 over 4.